Should I update to Windows 11? October 2025 update. Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. All right, you guys, the time is here. October the 14th, 2025 is upon us. Windows 10's end of support is imminent. With Windows 10 support coming to an end, it's time to consider just what you want to do. Now, I want to be really super duper clear about this. I'm still not saying that you have to update to Windows 11. Don't take this the wrong way. I'm going to recommend that you do so if you can, but that's all it is, a recommendation. As I've said in multiple places and at multiple times, Windows 10 will keep working beyond its end of support date. You can continue to use Windows 10 safely by essentially taking more responsibility for your own security. You could also consider enrolling in the Extended Security Update Program, the ESU, to, in a sense, just push that end of support date out one additional year. Eventually, though certainly not right away, some of your third-party applications may also end their support for Windows 10. If you don't want to or can't upgrade to Windows 11, keep calm and carry on in Windows 10. All right, let's talk about Windows 11. It's now 4 years old. It's a fine version of Windows from my perspective. I have been using it daily almost since the day it was released, and I've been happy with it from the start. I have it on both my primary desktop machine and my laptop. I've long said that it really just feels like a super big feature update to Windows 10 than it does a completely different version of Windows. The taskbar was moved and there's a somewhat different look and feel to it, but it's pretty much the same operating system. Now, I know not everyone feels this way, but from my perspective, there just wasn't that much to get used to when I switched. It and I just kept on working. Now, until now, my take was that Windows 11 rated a big eh. There just wasn't any compelling reason to switch. However, since Windows 10's end of support is imminent, I think it's time to consider the change, as long as your hardware supports it. Yes, one frustrating aspect of Windows 11 is its system requirements. Many machines, heck, even some relatively new ones, fail the compatibility test. There are workarounds for installing Windows 11 if your machine isn't up to the requirements. Microsoft has disabled many of the previous workarounds, and those that are still working may be disabled as well at some point. Microsoft has also indicated that machines updated to Windows 11 through those workarounds may not receive updates or may have other issues that Microsoft simply won't address. New machines, of course, are likely and actually have had Windows 11 pre-installed for some time. Great. Keep it. It's fine. There's no reason to run away from Windows 11. As I said, I use it every day, and it's just as fine as Windows 10, in my opinion. Now, I do want to talk a little bit about what I call the every other version curse. I want to be clear, this is in no way a reason to avoid Windows 11, but some might take it as one. I find it at least curious. Here's how it goes. Windows XP, super popular. Windows Vista, not so much. Windows 7, once again, super popular. Windows 8, not so much. Windows 10, on over a billion machines, very popular to this day. Windows 11, it remains to be seen. Now, it's as much superstition as anything else, and by itself, like I said, it's not a reason to avoid anything, particularly since there's been no word about any successor to Windows 11. And yet, there does seem to be a pattern. Make of it what you will. Now, to say Windows 11 elicits strong opinions in some people is perhaps an understatement. I want to address some of the more common ones. Everyone hates Windows 11. No. Here's the thing. You're only likely to hear from people who are experiencing issues. They look for help or just vent in various public forums. The people who like it the people for whom it's just working are quietly getting on with their work. I'm convinced there are many, many more of them than there are haters. Microsoft is evil, spying, scanning, etc. Well, honestly, that's not a Windows 11 problem. I know some feel Windows 11 is worse in some Microsoft is evil kind of way, but I don't see it. Windows 10 introduced much of the telemetry people complain about. To the best of my knowledge, Windows 11 hasn't made that significantly worse. Windows 11 pushes things on me that I don't want. That's not a Windows 11 problem either. Seriously, every version of Windows included features and functionality that many, though again not all, people objected to. Some people grew to like the new features, and some of the features just disappeared. In addition, many of the current complaints aren't about Windows 11 per se, but about specific features being introduced and pushed hard across both Windows 10 and 11. What's worthy of your ire is how Microsoft is pushing those features, like OneDrive. Microsoft is colluding with hardware manufacturers to force us to buy new machines. Oh, hell no. Honestly, this conspiracy theory frustrates me to no end. No one is forcing you to purchase a new machine. Stick with Windows 10. Switch to Linux. Use one of the hardware requirement bypasses. None of those options require you to spend a dollar. Yeah, eventually, you're likely to get a new machine. Not because anyone forced you to, but because it was time on your own schedule. That's been the case since PCs were invented. As a side effect, you'll have a machine that then meets the new hardware requirements. You're just a Microsoft shill. I often get accused of being on Microsoft's payroll, and for the record, I haven't been for decades, and it ended long before askleo. I'm supposedly getting paid to endorse them. I have yet to see a check, or I'm some kind of Microsoft apologist. When I recommend you consider Windows 11, it triggers the anti-Microsoft crowd something fierce. I'm a realist. I have lots of complaints about Microsoft and Windows. Lots. Trust me on this. But I also realize that leaving Microsoft and Windows behind isn't in the cards for many people, including a lot of my audience. Railing against all of Microsoft's evil, of which I agree there is much, wouldn't be helpful. Helping people switch to something else would benefit only a small portion of my audience. Instead, I try to help people make informed decisions and work within the system they have. So, bottom line, it's time to think about moving to Windows 11. If your machine can run Windows 11 and the PC Health Check app will tell you, then it's time to consider what you'll do next. Your options? Upgrade to Windows 11 now. Revert to Windows 10 if you can't stand it or have other issues. Wait. Upgrade to Windows 11 when you get a new machine that comes with it pre-installed. Stay with Windows 10, or use this as an excuse to switch to Linux. Whichever you choose, please make sure you take a complete system image before changing anything so that you can revert to what you have right now if something doesn't work out. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/135037. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.